A very warm welcome to all of you. My name is Sahil Gupta. I am ranked 19th in this year's civil service examination. This has been my third attempt. My background is I come from Haryana, Jhajjar district in Haryana. I graduated from VIT University in the year 2013. I am a civil engineer by training. My interests and hobbies are watching and playing football and reading poetry at times when I get times. So today we will be talking about civil service, how to crack this examination, because there are so many myths around this examination. I think the first thing that we need to keep in mind while preparing for this examination is consistency, and we do not lose momentum while preparing for the exam. As my colleague has talked about, he has mentioned all the books that we need for the prelims examination. I will be primarily talking about essay and ethics in details. But before that, I would like to tell you about my journey, how my journey has been. My journey started in the year 2013, rather I would say 2012. It was the fourth year of my college when I started, when I decided that I should be sitting for this examination. So I dropped out of the placements. I didn't sit for the placement. I decided to get all the NCRTs. I started preparing at that point of time. I covered the basic books, these like Lakshmikant, Bipin Chandra, and all these books. I started preparing at the college level. But I gave my first attempt in the year 2014. I scored decent. I got through the prelims because at that time there was CSET. I scored very decently in CSET. I got through mains. But I couldn't get through interview. I scored very less marks in interview. My marks in interview were at that point among the lowest of that attempt, because I scored only 110 out of 275. Because my interview got really bad, I got really nervous, and it seemed to me that when I have come this far, coming to the interview stage and yet not able to qualify, I was a little heartbroken. But then I decided, okay, life is not over, we have to move on. So I decided to move on. In my second attempt, again I got through prelims, but I missed the mains by 6 or 7 marks. This has been a third attempt, and I am able to secure a good rank, a fair rank, 19. Now I would like to talk about GS mains, because he has already talked about GS prelims in detail. So my strategy for GS mains was, I prepared what I call my own files. First of all, what you need to do is you need to go through the syllabus. Just take a printout of the syllabus, write it on an A4 sheet, and stick it on your walls. So that first of all, you need to remember the syllabus, because whatever piece of information that you are going to read, you must be able to know where to apply that information. So what I did was, I prepared these files. When you start, it takes a lot of time to read newspaper. It may take 2 hours or 3 hours. But gradually, when you will prepare your own notes, it depends on you whether you want to prepare handwritten notes or you want to use Evernote or whatever other application that is present. I preferred handwritten notes because of that I was able to recall things more easily. They come to me naturally since I was practicing and writing and making my own notes on a very daily basis. Now if we talk about GS, then primarily it has two parts. One is the static portion. Your static portion will be covered from your NCRTs. But for the dynamic portion, you have to go for newspapers and magazines. So I primarily used to follow the Hindu. And for magazine, I used to read only Yojana and Frontline at times when I used to find that there has been something good that has been coming in Frontline. So I used to follow it at times. Plus the Vision IS current affairs material, because it is a very concise one. I used to make notes out of that material as well, and I used to compile all these things into the files that I have created, which I have built up over a period of time. When it comes to newspaper reading, I must say that when you will start, it will take time, but don't lose hope. Just keep going. You will realize after some time that you are getting more familiar with the topics. Your notes are getting more updated, and you will be able to deal with the topics that comes in the mains, which are dynamic nature, in a more easy and relaxed manner. Because when you will be writing mains, there won't be any time. There will be only 3 hours and you have to attempt 20 questions. So you need to be very well drilled in order to attempt those 20 questions. If you're not well drilled, if you don't have all the material in your mind, then there's no time there to just go and think. You have to be well drilled. Your material must be there. You must be able to recall it quickly and write it down. Now I would like to talk about, all of you must be knowing that all the four papers of GS are 240 marks each. I would now like to talk about your paper GS4, which is Ethics, Integrity and Aptitude. Now in this paper, how many of you have you seen the syllabus for this paper? Anyone has seen the syllabus for this paper? Okay. So if you see the syllabus, then there is primarily 6 or 7 parts in the syllabus. One is your attitude, which talks about your thoughts and behavior, then your ethics and values, then your emotional intelligence, then the moral thinkers and the philosophers that's come, and then your ethics in public administration. There are some certain technical terms in here, probity, citizen charters, what is the difference between code of ethics and your code of conduct. These are very technical terms that you must be aware. So my source again was it was lexicon, because lexicon provided a very good insight. All the words, the meaning of all the words were very clearly mentioned, and you must be able to identify what is the difference. What is the difference between ethics and values? What is the difference between morality and ethics? You must be very familiar with these terms. And then the second part is your case study. So for case study, I think 7 case study comes in the exam, and each is, I guess, 20 marks, so it becomes 140 marks straight away. So while attempting I got 125 in ethics, which is a very decent score. So my strategy was, I attempted paper from the back. I went to the case study section first, because that is more of an analytical nature, where you have to analyze what is already given. So for that, you need to practice a lot. And for that, you can join Vision IAS test series as well, because I think they provide very good and concise answers, where the questions are of more of analytical nature. Then, moving forward, in case study, the way you attempt it, first you need to, when you will be writing a case study, I used to always write it in first person, like I or we, using the first person pronoun. Second, we need to identify in a case study that what is the ethical dilemma here, that which two values are at stake. For example, there can be such a case study where privacy as well as security, these two can be on a collision course, and then we need to find a right and fine balance between these two while writing. Also, while you will be preparing for your, also in case studies, you need to use the thinkers and the philosophers. Like, we can use thinkers and philosophers like Gandhi, Ambedkar, Kant, Socrates, Aristotle. And since my option is political science and international relations, so I have borrowed very heavily from that option as well while preparing for my ethics paper. Now coming back to the, after completing the case studies, coming back to the question sections, I would say your focus, all the thinkers and administrators, we must study in detail. For example, you can make very short notes on various administrators like M.S. Swaminathan, Homi J. Bhabha, Verghese Kurien, Vinod Rai, E. Sridharan. I made very concise notes, and wherever I have to give examples on them, examples on good administrative steps that have been taken, I gave these examples. This is about ethics. Now we'll talk a little about essay. So in essay, I have scored this time 164 marks. My essay journey has been a little up and down. It has been a little cursed and rough, because in my first attempt I got 142. I hardly wrote any 1 or 2 essay before going into the mains. So I thought, okay, since I have scored well in the first attempt, I will surely do well in the second attempt. But in the second attempt, I scored 90 marks only, which was very low at that point of time. So I decided, know that I need to do more practice. I need to write a lot. So then I decided to join a test series. And I wrote 4 or 5 essays this time. I've secured fairly good marks. Now in essay, what we need to do, the first thing is, I think the first paper that you're going to write will be of essay. And essay is one such paper where you can express yourself very freely. You need not be afraid. Your language has to be crisp and simple, and you have the freedom to express yourself whatever you feel like. Now, the main thing is each section will have 4 options, and there will be 2 sections, and each essay will be of 125 marks with 1200 words each. So now what we will do is, first of all, we need to identify the correct essay. The general perception is, if I write a essay on a separate topic, or which is a different one, then I will secure more marks, which is, I think, is actually a myth, because you must identify the essay which you are most comfortable with, on which you have content, on which you think you can express yourself very well. Second, when you look at the question paper, there will be, I guess, what happened with me was, I got confused between two essays, two topics. One, this time I wrote on, in the section A, I wrote on, if development is not engendered, it will be endangered. This was one of the essays. And second, I wrote on cybersecurity. So in the first one, I looked at the question paper, and straight away I crossed down the two. After 4, I crossed down the 2 that I will not attempt these two. So out of the 2, I got to the back of my paper. I scribbled a little. I wrote down all the content that I can generate at that point of time, and then I started writing. So what you can do, the general problem with people is they think that they don't feel comfortable like how to start an essay. So what I did this time around is I made a separate small notebook for quotes, where I divided that if a political essay will come, I wrote 10 quotes for that, and I hardly remember 2-3 out of those 10. Similarly, if a science essay will come, these are my 10 quotes, I will use them. If an economic essay will come, or a philosophical one will come, these are my 10 ones, and I will juggle them up and do my thing. Then we can also look up to, we can quote everyday examples into essays. For example, I remember in my home district, the government has used active trackers to control the female feticide, or to increase the child sex ratio. So this was a step which has been taken 2 years back, because the district from where I came from has a very drastic sex ratio of around 750 or 760. And now it has reached 900 mark this year itself, child sex ratio at birth. So the administration used active trackers, where if there is an ultrasound machine, if it is misused, then it will send a message to the CMO, who can take the required action under PCPNDT. So such kind of examples I mentioned in my essay. Next is, you can use your data to supplement your essay. Like, for example, the essay which I wrote, I quoted data from HDI as well as GII, that because of the inequality, the gender inequality, there has been a 29% economic loss to our GDP. So I mentioned that as well, because whatever you are right, there must be some facts behind that. So I tried to mention to supplement that with my own facts. Then coming to the language must be very simple. You need not go for any. The language must be crisp and simple. Then the next thing is, what we do we divide our essay into various sections, and there must be organic interlinkages within your sections. For example, the one I wrote, It talked about the keywords in that were development and gender. So I started with the quote of Simone de Beauvoir, who said that sex is natural gender is social, differences are natural, but discrimination is social. So this is how I started my essay. And then moving forward, I defined development. I defined like how the paradigm of development is evolving in itself. Like a few, like a 20 years down the drain, we were looking at the idea of economic development. Now in the 21st century, we are more talking about the idea of sustainable development. Then I defined development from the perspective of a common man. You can imagine like for a common man, what would development be? So I talked about public service delivery, because what would a common man want? He would want his sadak, pani, bijli at nominal cost. This is what he would want. Then I linked it with the second half of my essay and I wrote, what if this development is not endangered? What are the losses that we might suffer if in case the development is not related to your gender empowerment? So I wrote all about the health issues. I related it with the education sector, with the social security, with safety of women. I wrote on all those topics. Then also I related it with the left wing insurgency, with the insurgency in Jammu and Kashmir and Northeast. So I made all these things that I mentioned. Then you can also use quotes while interlinking. Like for example, I mentioned that Einstein has stated that imagination is more important than knowledge. So I mentioned it. There was one more of Helen Keller who said, keep your face to the sunshine and you won't see the shadows. So these quotes you can use while changing your paragraphs to give it a more classical flow while writing an essay. Then in the essay part itself, then I talked about what we normally do. I took the political, economic, social, psychological, behavioral. I took all these aspects and I wrote on them. Then I talked about what if there will be gender equality. I created an imaginary situation and then I talked about it, where I talked about it. If the woman is empowered and educated, then the democratic structures, the justice delivery, sustainable development, as well as there will be a grassroots revolution that can take place. So while writing, you can borrow very heavily from newspapers, from Yojana, or from your or the data and the content will automatically come from your GS papers. This all what you can do for essays. Don't forget to do one thing while writing an essay, and that is make sure that you tie up the loose ends, because what we do in essays, we ask a lot of questions. We tend to ask a lot of questions. That in my essay, I ask questions like, what if development is not engendered, what will happen then? What if it gets engendered? How will we make it engendered? How there will be women equality? So all these questions that I'm asking, I must try and provide a solution to all these problems. So I tried to do that at my best. Then you can also quote examples from the history. Like I quoted example of Sarojini Naidu and Kumari Sarla Devi from the history. So you can also borrow from history as well. You can borrow from present situation. I also related it with globalization and its impact, where I mentioned about Indra Nooyi, Sheryl Sandberg, and give contemporary examples to make my essay more effective. Finally, at the end, what you need to do is don't end essay on a pessimistic note. Always end it on a positive note that there is hope for improvement. Because what I did in my second attempt, the essay that I wrote, it gave a sense of being anti-establishment. It gave a sense of being a pessimistic essay in nature. And that is why I realized that I've scored such low marks in essay. So while writing essay, just make sure that the essay has a very positive vibe about it. Then coming to the final part of interview, I have attended two interviews. This was my second interview. My interview was on first day. One suggestion I would like to give you, if you write your mains very well, then don't take a long break, because this is the mistake which I did in my first attempt. My mains examination went fairly well, and then I took a break of about 1 or 2 months, because of which I lost momentum and I couldn't recover and I couldn't get back into the flow. So don't take a long break, just keep continuing your preparation. If you are from this near Delhi region, then your interview will come, I think will come very early, within the first or second week itself. So you might not get a month or 2 months to prepare. So keep your preparation handy. Also, don't panic in the interview, because I panicked in my first interview. I got so panicked that I was not able to reply a very simple question like why president is a part of parliament. And because of not able to handle pressure and panicking at that point of time, I scored such low marks. So my strategy would be like, be confident, just be yourself, fill in the gap with honesty, don't fake anything, just be yourself while filling the gap, because that will form the basis of your interview. While answering questions, there will be times in the interview when they will try to check your confidence level. So like with me, while I was replying to the international questions, there came a time where they told me that you should not have taken this optional, you should not have taken this subject as your optional. But at that point of time, I felt like it came as a shock from them. But then I just kept going. I tried to answer all the questions to the best of my capabilities, and I scored a decent 165 marks, plus my mains marks of 904, total to 1069, and I got this 19th rank. If there are any queries, then I would be happy to take it. I took coaching from Shubhra ma'am, Shubhra Ranjan ma'am. I totally relied on the notes. For international relations sections, I did newspaper and a little bit of world focus. That's it. I think if you will read newspaper very honestly, make notes out of it, makes note of Yojana, because if you see Yojana, one topic like health or education, if you are reading it sensibly, it has 10 or 12 articles in it. So your whole health and education or whatever sector is that gets completed. If you make note out of it, you don't have to go to multiple sources. So don't make this mistake of going to multiple sources. Just stick to one source, which you think is the best, which is reliable for you. And that's it, nothing. You need to net very extensively. Just search down all the things, make very small notes. Because what I used to do, I used to make a lot of notes. I didn't use online, but make notes online. I used to note it down myself. And then at the end of it, I used to make small notes out of those notes. So this is how I did.
You scored well in the option and all three.
No. I scored drastically during my second attempt. This time I scored 270, which is a decent score. I scored very badly during the second attempt, somewhere around 188. So these have fluctuated. When you don't write exams, when you don't practice, you're bound to suffer. This is the reality. And you have to just, consistency is the key word. Just keep working hard. Don't think about the end result. The moment you start thinking about, am I good enough to make it? Or, because like till 30th of May, I was also preparing for my fourth attempt. It is after the result that you get into this feeling that, oh, now we have become IAS. But IAS is not like anybody having this super intellectual entitlements. Nobody's like this. I'm a very average student. I've scored 75.8% marks in my 12th class. So just be it. Just go for the exam. Keep preparing. Keep working hard. And I'll leave the result on God. He will take care of it. When you will read, I think, 10 to 12 articles, I think there will be 6 to 7, which will primarily of much use. If you find a good clipping of a good diagram, say in environment there comes a whole list of SDGs, your sustainable development goals come in, you cut that off, paste it on. Then new schemes are coming. You read, you find some good data, jot it down. You find some good point where environment is related to women, or how sustainability is related to accessibility, or how interlinkages have been formed, just note them down one by one. And this is how you can prepare the notes. It will take time, but don't go for multiple sources then. Once you note it down at one point of time, at one place, then just stick to it. Rely on it 100%, it will do for you. Sorry? Yeah, leave for the last month, I guess. Like if the exam this time was in December and I read till November. Internal security, I read Vision IAS notes. and search on internet, there's so much material. What you can do is, you can imagine the map of India, then you can see like in Northeast, which are the states that we have problem, which are the states in which we have insurgency, what are the groups, what are the problems, arms, drug trafficking, all these problems. You know what are the problems with Pakistan, try to know the problems with Nepal, with China, make separate notes like country wise. That will be a big, that will like help you when you will be writing mains, because what happens is that when you are writing mains, there are 9 papers, 2 qualifying in 7, whose marks are going to count it, and they will be back to back, and you will not get any time for revision. So make sure you have all your material with you, which you are going to write, and you are well drilled up and well practiced. Sorry, ma'am. No, ma'am, I did not, because I find, because it like, in newspaper sufficient. And if there's anything that I thought I need to study, I used to go on internet and study it from there.
When should one start the preparation for essay, like which is the best time to do?
Ma'am, today is the best time, I would say.
And how should one go about it? Like, just start writing about any topics that from the previous year?
Yeah, ma'am, just pick up the previous year papers and see what are the topics. You might not be knowing, have information or content about all the 8 topics that are given. Pick the one that you are most familiar with. You think that, okay, this is what I knew something about it. Try and write it. Give it to your friends. They will review it. They will review the language as well as the content. Because what we are often confused is, which is more important? The language is more important or the content is more important? I think both are equally important. We need to emphasize equally on both of these to score good marks in essay. Revision plan, keep revising. This I did not have like a specific plan. On weekends, on Sunday, I used to sit and I used to revise whatever I studied in the previous 6 days. This was my plan, very simple. Yeah. Maybe maybe your essay then was more about schemes. I mentioned schemes, but in a very limited space. Say I devoted 2 paragraphs or, yeah, 2 paragraphs to schemes and what are their impacts. You also need to include what are the concepts related to women. Like Amartya Sen has given a concept of missing women, that our women are missing from the electoral democracy, that since they are not able to participate, we don't have gender equity. The moment they will get a political, they will get their political rights, they will eventually get economic equality over a due course of time. I mentioned 2-3, but I then, like I mentioned, we can talk after what I've written. There's no problem. I'll tell you in detail what all I've written.
And we can include diagrams also in the essay, like is it justified?
That depends on the nature of essay that has been asked. I would not say to draw diagrams. I would not say.
Number of hours you study.
The most difficult question, bro. So I never had this thing of studying for hours, like for going for hours, like 10, 12 hours, never. I used to set my target, like if this is one notebook or one book that I have to complete, then I used to give myself 2 days or 1 day. Whatever target I have in my mind, I then used to finish it in that day itself, in that deadline. I used to set deadlines rather than hours, because that is more suitable, that keeps you on fire, like, okay, I have to complete this. Yes, please. I think when you will be for mains, the last 3 months, like just before the exam, will be crucial. Study the rest of it as well, but the last 3 months will be very crucial. Don't miss anything from those. This is like my experience from the past 3 mains.
So he's referring to the prelims portion.
Prelims portion, study for the 12 months, entire 12 months.
So how can I choose the optional subject?
For choosing optional, I would say, first of all, you go and search all the previous year's papers. Like when I have to choose my optional, I was confused between political science and history. So what I did was, I took down the new question papers, then I saw the material that is available, what are the coachings that are available, because you also need to consider that fact in your mind as well. Then I bought some basic books, like one basic book I bought for each of the subject. I read it, I felt okay, political science is more comfortable because I'm more comfortable reading international relations, so I took political science. So this is the way that you can do, I think so. Newspapers in notes. This is a very tedious exercise, to be very frank, because what I did is I prepared files for this. Like, you take a file, make daily notes out of newspaper, whichever you think are important. Leave the political news aside. For example, अभी GST आ रहा है या कुछ और भी आ रहा है, तो you just note it down. आप करते जाइए उसको धीरे धीरे. Eventually, वो दो तीन महीने बाद you will have sufficient amount of GST, sufficient amount of content on GST. They keep revising it. और सबसे पहले आप जब file बनाए तो make an index of it. That is why I say this, that syllabus is most important. First of all, go and read the syllabus that has been provided by UPSC, because that is like preamble of the constitution for you people. Just learn it straight away. And then, like, whatever information that has been coming in newspaper, that is just a piece of information. You must be knowing how to apply it, and that application will part only comes with experience.
Sir, which books is sufficient for both science?
Which book? Yeah, I read only O.P. Goba, and that too for reference. Like, if there's a definition I'm not clear about, if there's a concept I'm not able to get, I used to go to books. Otherwise, I stick to ma'am's notes. For international relation, yes, I read very extensively. I read from, I used to read C. Rajamohan articles. You can search them on net. Then Hindu is very good source. Suhasini Heather. Then if you keep reading, then there will be some writers you will develop a taste towards. So this happened with me, and this is how I went about it. Topic-wise. And try to make a file, because what happens is when we make notes in a notebook, we are not able to update it. Some are in this notebook, others are in this notebook, and your main's coming up, and you are not, you don't know where what is, and it will be all messed up.
So there are a lot of articles and everything is there in the newspaper and the magazines when you are making notes out of it. So how do you really decide that which information has to be noted down and which is?
That is why I am saying that please read the syllabus part first, because if you read the syllabus part, you will have greater clarity about which information to include and which to leave. Like, remove all the political news. Which politician is saying what, doing what, just leave it. What are the good schemes, initiatives, analysis? Because focus more on analysis. Read the two editorials that come, because they are the, like, the most important part of the newspaper.
Sir, do we need to read the non-fictional books like you mentioned out Amrita Sen's Missing Books?
I did read during my college. I read The Argumentative Indian, and I read India After Gandhi, Ramchandra Guha. These were the two books I read during my fourth year when I had time and I was doing my BTech final year project. At that point of time, if you think you have time, then you can read. There's no compulsion that, like, you have to read. It is simply depends on your time management and if you have time.
Nowadays, there's a lot of hue and cry regarding Indian Express and Hindu. And a lot of people say that you should go for both.
I primarily relied on the Hindu. During my interview time, I tried to go for Indian Express as well. But then I realized that I'm not able to, like, do justice to both of them. Since I developed a habit of reading Hindu over a period of 2 years, so I thought that, no, I was not very happy reading Express. So whatever you are happy with, whatever you are comfortable with, read one among the two. That is your personal decision.
Part A of physics paper is static or dynamic?
Sorry?
Part A of physics paper is static or dynamic?
Part A. If you will see the syllabus, you will see that it is static. But the questions they will ask are of dynamic nature. For example, in ethics paper, I remember I was reading one article newspaper where it was like there was two officers that have been inducted in the Delhi Commission of Women, and they were acid victims. Now, these were the two officers that that will attend the victims who will come over. So what will happen is, if say I am an acid attack victim and I am going to register the complaint, and if I see that the other person is also a victim, obviously she will show more empathy towards me, and there will be what I would say the grievance redressal mechanism. There will be no clogging in that. So I found that as a very good step, and I mentioned that in my ethics paper, that these are some of the steps that we can do, or I can take as an administrator. Yeah, I have read a little bit of Iqbal. नहीं तेरा नशे मन कसर सुल्तानी के गुंबद पर तू शाही है बसेरा कर पहाड़ों की चट्टानों. Any other questions? Yeah, I have made notes for everything. This has been my mantra. Maybe I've got a result after 4 years, but it has paid results. And it will pay you good dividends, trust me. So make results, make your short notes. Don't just borrow notes from your friends. Make your own notes, work hard, just simple.
Sir, there are sources, online sources for Hindu analysis. Sir, we need to go for that or need to read the whole newspaper?
Why won't you want to read the original stuff, man? Just read the original stuff. No, if you are facing any problem in the analysis part, then you can go. But if you're finding that, I think if you will read Hindu for 2-3 months, you will find it very legible, ke haan ho jayega. So I would say go to the original stuff, stick to it.
So are there any tips to make notes?
No. Keep writing. Any other question?
Sir, how did you cover the theory and thinkers part of political science?
Theory and thinkers? I scored 125 in this year, and I still think I'm very weak in that part. If I get a chance to rewrite mains, I would work on that part. But for that part also, I relied on Shubhra Ma'am notes completely. I read OP Goba once. I used to use it as a dictionary, like if I have any doubt in a certain section, say democracy or justice, then I used to refer it. Otherwise, I relied on Ma'am's notes. That did for me.
Sir, two questions.
Yeah.
Any coaching in any institute?
I took a lot of coaching too. Sorry?
Is there study material sufficient to clear prelims?
It is? Is there?
Is there study material provided by the institute sufficient to clear prelims?
Yeah. Easily. For prelims, you need to focus on NCERTs, newspapers, and you can pick any one current affair booklet from the market, whichever you wish to.
CSAT
sold 4 or 5 papers before the exam, that's it. I think we need to score only 66 marks out of 200, up greater than 66. I think that will help. You can do that with 4 or 5 papers. Ma'am, I read B.V. Rao for World History. Plus, I also refer to the Vision IAS. There are 2 booklets. One is, I think, starts from World War I, and the other is before that. I refer to the second one. Because I find the first one, there's a lot more to study, so I skipped it. Any other questions? Thanks a lot. Exactly the way you have told yourself. First, read the portion, whatever it has been given in the syllabus. Like if the first 10 chapters are coming, I would read them. Then I would go to solve the paper. Yeah. When you're beginning, it is good to cover it subject-wise. But once you are like 1 month or 2 months before the prelims, go for the comprehensive papers, because that is what will come in the examinations. Any other? Okay, thanks a lot. Thank you for the session.